Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced a massive economic relief package worth rupees 20 lakh crores yesterday, also known as the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman announced a slew of measures that constituted this massive economic package today. As part of the key announcements made by the Finance Minister, a fresh definition of MSMEs was announced today. Now, this definition, ladies and gentlemen, has added a new criteria of turnover in the definition. As per the revised definition, any firm with an investment of up to Rs. 1 crore and turnover under Rs. 5 crores will be classified as micro. Any firm or company with an investment up to Rs. 10 crores and turnover of up to Rs. 50 crores will be classified as small. Similarly, any firm with an investment of up to Rs. 20 crores and turnover under Rs. 100 crores will be classified as medium. As part of various other measures and announcements for MSMEs, the Finance Ministry also announced collateral-free loan, a loan which is provided without any guarantee for MSMEs worth Rs. 3 lakh crores. This will benefit 45 lakh units of MSMEs so that they can save their jobs and start work during the pandemic. For those MSMEs which have been stressed with NPAs during the time of pandemic, a debt provision of about 20,000 crores has been announced by the Finance Ministry. A Rs. 50,000 crore equity infusion through a special fund has also been announced by the Ministry, which will help the MSMEs expand capacity and increase business during these times. Now, talking about the employees, employers and the various measures and announcements for EPF, the Finance Ministry has announced a liquidity relief worth Rs. 2,500 crores for EPF establishments across the country. The Finance Ministry also said that the EPF contribution will be paid by the Government of India for the coming 3 months till August 2021. This, the Ministry believes, is likely to benefit more than 72 lakh employees in the country. As part of other measures and announcements, the Finance Ministry has also said that the EPFO contribution has been reduced from an earlier 12% to 10%. Now, what does this mean for you? Any contribution that you're making to the EPF from your salary has been reduced. It earlier stood at 12% and it has now reduced to 10%. Now, this means you will have more salary to take back home. Now, this will be fully guaranteed by the Government of India. A Rs. 45,000 crore partial credit guarantee scheme has also been announced for the non-banking financial companies. Now, other details of the mega economic package include an extension of up to 6 months with no cost to the contractors to be provided by all the central government agencies, which includes the Ministry of Road, Transport, Railways, etc. A reduction of Rs. 25% of the existing rates of TDS and TCS will be applicable from tomorrow till 31st March 2021 and is likely to release 50,000 crores. Now, this is not all, ladies and gentlemen. The Finance Ministry will be announcing more details and more of what constitutes this elaborate, massive 20 lakh crore economic relief package starting tomorrow.